Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfat. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace the President of the Arab League's Arab Tourism Organization, the ATO, and a member of the Higher Coordinating Committee for Joint Arab Action, Bender bin Fahd Al Fahd, and a number of officials at the organization. The President of the ATO presented His Majesty with the Arab Tourism First Degree Medal, which is the highest medal awarded to kings and presidents. The medal was awarded to His Majesty in appreciation of his support to the ATO, which resulted in making numerous achievements that serve tourism at both the regional and local levels. The ATO president delivered a speech in which he stated that the award comes in appreciation of His Majesty's contribution to tourism and his support to the organization and its goals since its establishment through joint cooperation with Bahrain Tourism and Exhibition Authority, as well as on the occasion of Manama being selected the Arab Capital of Tourism 2013. His Majesty welcomed the ATO President and the accompanying delegation, expressing thanks and appreciation for the medal, which also reflects the appreciation of the continuous efforts of Bahrain to develop the tourism sector as a major contributor to the national economy. His Majesty noted that the Kingdom's civilization and cultural assets have made it a leading destination for global tourism. His Majesty praised the cooperation between the Ministry of Industry, Commerce and Tourism and Bahrain Tourism and Exhibition Authority, affirming that the Kingdom will implement major projects in cooperation with the ATO. He noted the Arab world's touristic and natural assets and the historical monuments testify to its ancient history, which makes it a leading tourist destination. His Majesty praised the achievements of the ATO and its role in developing joint Arab action in the field of tourism. He wished the presidents of the ATO and its affiliates further success and progress. For his part, the ATO president expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for his keenness on developing joint cooperation between the Kingdom and the organization. He praised the progress of Bahrain in the prosperous era of His Majesty the King. He also praised the leading touristic achievements and its provision of outstanding services and infrastructure for tourists and investors in the field of tourism. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace the personal representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, who presented to His Majesty the winners of the King Hamad Award for empowering youth to achieve sustainable development goals. The meeting commenced with the recitation of the Holy Quran.
Thank you. حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى الخليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها السيدات والسادة، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. خير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ خالد عبد الرحمن الرئيس.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إنا عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها وأشفقن منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. ليعذب الله المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات ويتوب الله على المؤمنين والمؤمنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. صدق الله العظيم.
يتفضل سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة.
His Majesty the King then delivered the following speech.
حفظه الله ورعاه بإلقاء كلمة بهذه المناسبة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نرحب بكم أجمل ترحيب، ويسعدنا أن نشهد معكم اليوم نتائج المشاركة في أعمال الجائزة التي نعتز برعايتها لما تحمله من تطلعات وآمال نتشارك فيها مع المجتمع الدولي لبلوغ الأهداف التنموية المستدامة من أجل عالم أفضل حيث يتمتع الجميع بحق العيش في سلام ورخاء ونماء. كما تأتي الجائزة بأهدافها النوعية لتعبر عن قناعتنا الراسخة بأهمية الدور الذي يجب أن يتولاه الشباب في صياغة مستقبلهم وإشراكهم في برامج التنمية والتطوير لاستيعاب تطلعاتهم وإعدادهم الإعداد السليم لأداء واجباتهم اتجاه أوطانهم بشكل مسؤول وبما يمكنهم من وضع أسس وملامح ذلك المستقبل المشرق. ونود بهذه المناسبة أن نهنئ الفائزين بالجائزة في كافة فئاتها من أفراد ومؤسسات حكومية وخاصة وأهلية، ونحيي لهم جهودهم في رفعة وتمكين الشباب من منطلق إيمانهم بدورهم الريادي في بناء أوطانهم والنهوض بمجتمعات. ولا يسعنا كذلك إلا أن نشكر الابن العزيز سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد الخليفة ممثلنا الشخصي للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب، على إشرافه المباشر على أعمال هذه المبادرة الدولية، والشكر كذلك لهيئات الأمم المتحدة المعنية ولوزارة الشباب والرياضة وأعضاء لجان التحكيم على جهودهم الكريمة لتحقيق الأهداف النبيلة للجائزة. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
كلمة
His Highness Sheikh Nasser then delivered a speech in which he expressed sincere gratitude and appreciation for His Majesty's continuous support to the youth in Bahrain and across the world. His Highness hailed His Majesty's pioneering role in globally establishing an initiative directed towards the youth through the establishment of His Majesty's Youth Award, a program set to empower the youth while striving towards attaining sustainable development. He also hailed His Majesty's role in encouraging countries as well as public and private corporations to support the youth and empower them to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals as ratified by the United Nations, which were endorsed by world leaders in the first edition of the 2015 Global Summit, with participation of over 663 youth from 87 different countries, which reflected the noble objectives of the award as well as its positive impact on the advancement of the organization's work in the respective countries. His Highness pledged to support the youth and to continue to provide empowering initiatives and expressed aspirations for a successful second edition of His Majesty's Award to reinforce the innovative role Bahrain plays in endorsing the youth. His Highness affirmed Bahrain's keenness to involve youth regionally and internationally in achieving the United Nations SDGs. His Highness thanked the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, the Ministry of Youth and Sports Affairs, the United Nations Economic and Social Council, the United Nations Development Programme, Bahrain, as well as to the members of the Supreme and Provisional Panel of Judges for their cooperation.
وهذا الانتشار الواسع من خلال وصول عدد المشاركين في النسخة الأولى من الجائزة إلى 663 مشارك من 87 دولة مختلفة. لتعكس هذه المشاركة الكبيرة الأهداف النبيلة التي تحملها الجائزة ومردودها الإيجابي على مسيرة الارتقاء بمنظومة العمل في تلك البلدان والدور المرتقب من دور الشباب في تحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة لتشق طريقها السليم نحو البناء والتطور وإحلال التنمية المستدامة. سيدي، إننا نعاهد جلالتكم أن نمضي قدما في دعم الشباب وتقديم المبادرات العالمية الرائدة في مجالات تمكين الشباب، وأن تكون النسخة الثانية من جائزة جلالتكم إن شاء الله نسخة ناجحة بكافة المقاييس تستقطب أكبر شريحة من الشباب من مختلف دول العالم، وأن نعزز من المكانة الرائدة التي حققتها مملكة البحرين عالمياً في تبنيها للعديد من قضايا الشباب حتى أصبحنا عاصمة عالمية للشباب. وسيستمر البناء ما تحقق من إنجازات والعمل على تعزيز آليات الشراكات مع الجميع لمواكبة المتطلبات والاحتياجات، حيث سيشكل الوفاء بالتزاماتنا الدولية والمتضامنة على الصعيد العالمي انطلاقة حقيقية لبلوغ أهداف التنمية المستدامة. ختاماً يا صاحب الجلالة، نؤكد لجلالتكم أن مملكة البحرين حرصت على تحمل مسؤولياتها الإقليمية والدولية تجاه تحقيق إشراك الشباب في تحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة بمختلف أبعادها، وقطعنا شوطاً كبيراً في تنفيذ المبادرات السامية لجلالتكم للنهوض بالشراكة الدولية، والتي تأتي معززة لدور البحريني المتواصل من العمل الإنمائي. وفي هذه المناسبة أود أن أتقدم بالشكر والتقدير إلى وزارة الخارجية ووزارة شؤون الشباب والرياضة والمجلس الاقتصادي الاجتماعي بالأمم المتحدة وبرنامج الأمم المتحدة الإنمائي في مملكة البحرين، وإلى أعضاء لجنة التحكيم العليا والأولوية على تعاونهم الوثيق والذي ساهم في إنجاح هذه المبادرة. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Then the United Nations Resident Coordinator and Resident Representative Amin al-Sharqawi delivered a speech in which he expressed pride in meeting His Majesty the King. He stated that the award embodies a progressive idea of development and is a confirmation of what is stated in the Bahrain National Action Charter of the Kingdom regarding the development of youth. He added that the award and the work on youth and sustainable development in general are an integral part of the strategic partnership framework. Al-Sharqawi also stated that the process behind the award was built on transparency and objectivity, a result of the appointment of an international team of award donors from the United Nations, as well as the adoption of impartial selection criteria and a state-of-the-art electronic system for the selection process. He affirmed that at the United Nations, the members aspire to open new doors of opportunity for cooperation with the Kingdom of Bahrain on pioneering initiatives to achieve the sustainable development goals and provide support to His Majesty the King. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and president of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa and the Ministry of Youth and Sports Affairs. He reiterated his congratulations to His Majesty the King on the great initiative in which the United Nations have been honored to take part.
وإنه ليست مصادفة أن تحمل جائزة تمكين الشباب والتي نحتفل بها اليوم اسم جلالتكم، فهي تعكس مستوى عاليا من الوعي والفكر الثاقب من لدنكم، كما تعكس الالتزام تجاه دور مملكة البحرين في تحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة والتي يسعدنا في الأمم المتحدة أن نتشارك معها على تحقيقه. ولذلك فإن هذه الجائزة القيمة تجسد دون شك فكراً تنموياً بارزاً لافتاً لجميع الأنظار حول العالم، فمن جهة تأتي تأكيداً لما جاء في ميثاق العمل الوطني البحريني الذي توافقت عليه غالبية الشعب البحريني لما فيه من حكمة وبعد نظر، وفي هذا السياق ما يفيد عناية الدولة بشكل خاص بنمو الشباب العقلي والبدني والخلقي ومراعاة الأسس الاقتصادية للمجتمع القائمة على مبدأ الحرية الاقتصادية والعدالة وتنويع النشاط الاقتصادي ومصادر الدخل والاستغلال الأمثل للموارد والثروات الطبيعية وصيانة الأموال العامة، وهو ما جعل البحرين تحقق مستوى متقدما في التنمية الاقتصادية. ومن جهة ثانية، فإن تبني مملكة البحرين لأهداف التنمية المستدامة 17 واعتمادها في خطة عمل حكومتها للأعوام المقبلة إلى جانب رؤيتها الاقتصادية 2030 التي تتقاطع في كثير من حيثياتها مع أجندة التنمية المستدامة، كل ذلك يشير أن مملكة البحرين ماضية بكل قوة وإرادة لتحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة دون تخلف أحد عن الركب.
Your Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa.
And on behalf of the award winners, Ms. Hadia Ali Shirazi gave the following speech.
It's a great honor for me to stand here before Your Majesty on this special occasion, which we are proud of. This celebration that brings us together with a leader who understands and believes in the importance of the active role played by young people in leading the world towards broad horizons of development and giving them the full opportunity to unleash their bright ideas and innovation to be the basis for the development of the world and the various components of sustainable development in it. Your Majesty, on this day, we bring to you a message of thanks and appreciation from the youth of the world, and I have the honor to speak on their behalf. Please allow me to express our sincere gratitude for your initiative to empower young people to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals, an initiative which is the first of its kind on a global level. These initiatives were launched by your illustrious kingdom, which showed its clear interest in the youth of the world and realized its importance. and realized its responsibilities towards the youth and was able to achieve an important international consensus, making this award widely spread because of its noble goals towards youth and the countries of the world. Your Majesty, we are proud to have participated in Your Majesty's award to empower young people to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. This award has provided us with a real and ideal opportunity to spread our creativity, ideas, and innovation towards achieving the goals of sustainable development, and to send a clear message to all officials in our countries that we are going to lead the world, and we are ready to participate in the development of its bright future and to let our ideas achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. Your Majesty, in the end, we would like to thank you once again for honoring us after our participation in Your Majesty's award to empower young people to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. And we highly value and appreciate Your Majesty's keenness to support the youth of the world. Thank you.
After that, His Majesty the King awarded the winners, and they are Ms. Hadia Ali Shirazi of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, who has worked on a range of initiatives to achieve the goals of sustainable development. The winner from the private sector, the Gulf Petrochemical Industries Company, GPIC, which contributed to the achievement of four indicators through education and training programs and environmental lectures. The award was received by GPIC's President, Dr. Abdurrahman Jawahari. The winner from the government sector, the Youth Foundation of the President of the Republic of Azerbaijan, which supports innovative ideas for youth. The award was received by the Chief of Staff of the Youth Foundation of the President of Azerbaijan, Mr. Faikh Gorbatov. The winner from the category of NGOs and international organizations, the Youth Organization for Development from the Republic of Sierra Leone, which aims to empower young people in many fields. The award was received by the organization's Coordinator of Development Programs, Mr. Uthman Sharif. His Majesty the King then honored the members of the Supreme Judging Committee, which consists of the Minister of Youth and Sports of the Arab Republic of Egypt, Engineer Khalid Mahmoud Abdulaziz, Minister of Youth of the United Arab Emirates, Shamma bint Sahel al-Mazrui. His Majesty also honored the members of the first jury that consists of the Director of the UNDP Regional Innovation Team in the Arab States, Ms. Jennifer Colville, Director of UNDP's World Youth Program, Ms. Noella Richard, UNDP Development Program Analyst in the Kingdom of Bahrain, Mr. Ali Salman Saleh, and the Regional Advisor for UNDP in the Arab States, Na'man Sayed. His Majesty was then presented with a commemorative gift. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace the United Arab Emirates UAE Minister of Culture and Knowledge Development, Noura bint Mohammed Al Kabi, and the Minister of Youth, Shamma bint Sahel Al Mazrui, on the occasion of their visit to the kingdom to participate in the King Hamad Award for Empowering Youth to Achieve Sustainable Development Goals. The two ministers conveyed the greetings of the UAE President, Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan, and the Deputy Vice President, Prime Minister and Ruler of Dubai, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Khalifa, and the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi, Deputy Supreme Commander of the UAE Armed Forces, Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, and their wishes of abundant health and happiness to His Majesty the King and further progress and prosperity to the kingdom. His Majesty affirmed the deep-rooted historic relations between Bahrain and the UAE and the development joint cooperation on all levels, expressing pride in the fraternal ties and the development they witness. They thanked His Majesty for participating in the ceremony, affirming youth and cultural cooperation and joint coordination between the two countries to achieve the common interests and goals. Noura bint Mohammed Al Kabi and Shamma bint Sahel Al Mazrui expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for supporting cooperation between the two countries, hailing the existing cooperation between the two countries in the cultural and youth fields. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to the first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Athletics Association, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, for ranking third place in the lightweight class of the Bahraini Strongest Man Championship. In the cable, His Majesty the King praised His Highness Sheikh Khalid's role and contribution to the success of the championship and his supervision of the High Organizing Committee and the Working Committees, which culminated in the success of the championship. His Majesty also sent a congratulatory cable to Captain Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa on winning first place in the middleweight class of Bahraini Strongest Man Championship, lauding his excellent level and fitness as well as persistence, wishing him success in upcoming championships. His Majesty also sent a congratulatory cable to Ahmad Hussein Al Ghaffaz on winning first place in the heavyweight class of Bahraini Strongest Man Championship, lauding his excellent level and wishing him success in upcoming championships. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to the first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Athletics Association, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, for ranking third in the lightweight class of the Bahraini Strongest Man Championship and the success of the event. His Royal Highness hailed His Highness Sheikh Khalid's achievement and expressed pride in the determination of His Highness and Bahraini youth to promote Bahrain in various sports events. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa met today at Qutbiyya Palace with a number of Muharraq's citizens. He affirmed that the kingdom, under the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, will continue to make achievements that benefit the people of Bahrain and grant them security and stability. His Royal Highness added that the misuse of social media is considered cyber terrorism and that it must be stopped. He added that the Bahraini community rejects the exploitation of social media for the purpose of disrupting social cohesion and spreading chaos. His Royal Highness emphasized that the kingdom continues to create an environment of coexistence and tolerance to stand in the face of sedition and division. The Prime Minister hailed the rich history of Muharraq, adding that its honorable stances, along with that of their brothers in the other regions of the kingdom, have foiled the attempts to disrupt national cohesion. His Royal Highness noted that the people of Muharraq serve as an excellent example of patriotism and loyalty. He expressed pleasure in meeting with the people of Muharraq, noting his keenness on listening to their concerns and opinions regarding their government status in the fields of health, education, housing and infrastructure. The premier underscored keenness to communicate with all the people of Bahrain to strengthen the national fabric and promote unity. He called on the people to instill the values of cohesion and unity in future generations to safeguard them against all attempts of division. He stated that the unprecedented challenges that face the region call for awareness against the plotted schemes that aim to stir chaos to maintain the nation's security and stability and continue its development and progress.
Thank you.
For his part, Dr. Mohammed Hassan Kamaluddin delivered a speech on behalf of the people of Muharraq, in which he expressed the thanks and appreciation of the people to His Royal Highness for his follow-up on the needs of Muharraq and for his efforts to further develop the area. He hailed His Royal Highness's national stances and his eminent role in the development of the kingdom, as well as his efforts to defend the causes of Bahrain and meet the aspirations of its people. Dr. Kamaluddin praised His Royal Highness's directives regarding the misuse of social media. He recalled the Premier's honorable stances in 2011, wishing him abundant health and happiness.
في تاريخها الحديث تغانم يا وجه الخير يا البارق الهتام.
During the meeting, poet Salim Ahmed Al-Manna'i recited a poem praising His Royal Highness's stances on his role in developing the kingdom.
والنفوس تزين من محرق وفرجانها صاغت الديفان مشاعر مثل كفين وإحساس مثل أمين بذوق وبساطة فاحت صدورنا ريحان على الطيبة وروح الأخوة بذرنا سنين كتب ربي إن يهدي سبأ هدهد سليمان وليت إن يهدي روحي لديرة البحرين كتب ربي إن يهدي سبأ هدهد سليمان وليت إن يهدي روحي لديرة البحرين لها لو نذوق المر ونخاوي الحرمان تركنا مضاجعنا وجينا لها ملبين جبل طور صم اسمه خليفة بن سلمان ولهسته الأعوان.
His Royal Highness Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Qutbiyya Palace a number of royal family members, officials, businessmen, journalists, media personnel and citizens. His Royal Highness affirmed that the people of Bahrain's loyalty to the leadership is acclaimed and its unification protected the kingdom and preserved its unity. He added that the kingdom will overcome all practices that incite division and hatred between people and it will not allow social media to become a platform for damaging people's reputations. His Royal Highness hailed the Council of Representatives and its members, affirming his respect and support to the representatives of citizens. The Prime Minister asserted his follow-up on citizens and their needs, urging to take advantage of modern technology communication to enhance national unity and serve development purposes. His Royal Highness expressed pleasure in the contribution of citizens, columnists and civil society organizations to warning against the negative effects of misusing social media websites, stressing that their contributions reflect Bahraini people's ethics and values. His Royal Highness discussed the upcoming elections in Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, the BCCI, wishing the Traders' House success in the elections. He added that BCCI had contributed to the commerce movement in the kingdom. He affirmed the government's keenness on supporting BCCI to ensure providing an atmosphere of openness and flexibility in order to achieve the aspirations of its members. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to the first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Athletics Association, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, for ranking third in the lightweight class of the Bahraini Strongest Man Championship and the success of the event. His Royal Highness hailed the role of His Highness in aiding the success of the championship and supporting and patronizing it. His Royal Highness affirmed that the success of the championship's success contributed in highlighting the youth's competencies, noting His Highness's role in organizing various events. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince sent similar cables to Captain Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa on winning first place in the middleweight class of Bahraini Strongest Man Championship, and to Ahmad Hussein Al Ghaffas on winning first place in the heavyweight class of Bahraini Strongest Man Championship, lauding his excellent level and wishing him success in upcoming championships. The first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Athletics Association and Honorary President of Bahrain Sports Federation for Disabilities, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, crowned the first place winners of the main competitions of the tournament, which ended yesterday. His Highness awarded Ahmad Al Ghaffas with a four-wheel drive vehicle after Al Ghaffas won first place in the heavyweight competitions, earning him the title of Most Powerful Man. His Highness expressed pleasure in the wide parts participation witnessed in the medium heavyweight competition. He continued to praise the unwavering support received from His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, crediting His Majesty for achieving the desired goal in this grand sports event, in addition to the numerous achievements made in various sports championships. His Highness also hailed the follow-up of the personal representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, which clearly reflected on the success of this event. His Highness Sheikh Khalid expressed happiness in the tournament for promoting the principle of brotherhood among the kingdom's youths and encouraging them to unleash their abilities in such sport in order to serve the development and advancement of the sports scene, as well as contributing to the discovery of talents that can be utilized. His Highness highlighted that excellent organization that presented the championship confirms the high professionalism of the Bahraini youth, stressing that the Supreme Organizing Committee and all the staff have exerted great efforts in running the competitions throughout the period leading up to the tournament. His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa crowned the winners of the first positions in the medium and heavyweight competitions. Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, Sheikh Faisal bin Rashid Al Khalifa, and Sheikh Abdullah Al Fatih bin Mohammed bin Salman Al Khalifa crowned the winners of the first lightweight category. His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa won third place, while Ismail Suwaid Al Amri won first place, and second place winner was Khalid Ali Dhafiri.
Thank you. The Bahrain's strongest man competition rolls down its curtains, conquering a new milestone for the kingdom. The competition, which took place from the 22nd to the 24th, reflects the level of progression of the sports and youth movement that has reached in the kingdom.
First of all, I would like to thank His Highness Sheikh Nasser and His Highness Sheikh Khalid for, looking and creating opportunities for the sports in the Kingdom of Bahrain. And I hope you'll see the kingdom successfully compete in the upcoming regions next to us, GCC countries. Also, I would like to thank His Highness Sheikh Khalid for giving the cancer patients this opportunity to be part of this event and giving them what they want in the future. As you know, they need someone to look at their goals and to take care of their needs in the future. And it's not something new for Sheikh Khalid to take care of them.
So we believe that for the sport to really grow and for everyone who is in the gym to really be motivated every day to go to the gym, that there should be a championship for them. There should be something that really they like and that they will always target so that they can every year practice and train very hard for it. So what His Highness Sheikh Khalid has done is really impressive and amazing, something world class, and a championship that we really need here in Bahrain, because we have a lot of people that go to the gym and after the gym they go to work, but after that what do? They go back to the gym again. But having a goal every year, a championship like this, world class, is something I think that's going to really grow the sport. It's going to keep everyone motivated to be athletic, to be to lift weights.
The initiative, which featured four weight categories, has given the participants a platform to perform to their best abilities and talents. The competitions included pulling a car, raising a tire and a car, pulling a rope, wrestling, and pulling a fish cage, along with musical and cultural programs to engage the athletes and visitors.
The competition is really amazing, especially since my training partner is the leading guy on the board, so I'm proud of him. We trained for 3 months for this competition in Spartan Gym, happy to represent. I just think it's really amazing that Sheikh Khalid actually had this event. It really made me meet a lot of people. I made a lot of new friends just getting ready for this competition.
And I feel great about this competition, first time for me. And I feel good that next time, if I didn't win this time, maybe I will win next time. And if I didn't win next time, maybe I'll try again. But I feel good to have a very great people like here. And I have to see the strongest man in the world. And I feel good, yeah. It's good to have a competition like this here.
An award ceremony took place to congratulate the winning participants, who have shown endless potential and high-level performances throughout the tournament, which highlights the kingdom's efforts encouraging and enhancing the sports and youth sectors. Today marks the conclusion of Bahrain's Strongest Man Championship, 3 days filled with excitement, entertainment and fierce competitions. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Yasmin Ibrahim.
Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa has announced that two coordination meetings spotlighting services and the environment themes of the government's action plan 2019-2022 will be held Sunday and Monday respectively. The meetings are in line with the outcomes of the government forum 2017, which was held under the patronage of His Royal Highness Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa and the initiative of His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, to hold workshops to determine mechanisms and identify the priorities of GAP 2019-2022. The two coordination meetings will be attended by Undersecretaries, Assistant Undersecretaries and other directors concerned with the themes of services and the environment. The Deputy Premier, also head of the Ministerial Committee for Social Services, Telecommunications and Information, will chair a workshop on the themes of services and environment, scheduled to be held on the 4th of March. The first workshop, held last November under the chairmanship of Deputy Premier Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, tackled the gaps, infrastructure, financial and economic themes. The second workshop, chaired by Deputy Premier Jawad Salim Al Arayad last January, focused on the government performance and the legislative themes of the government action plan 2019-22. Deputy Premier Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa will chair the final workshop themed Future Prospects. The Shura Council held its weekly session today, presided by its chairman Ali bin Salah Al-Saleh. The council completed discussing the second supplementary report of the Foreign Affairs, Defense and National Security Committee. It rejected a draft law suggested by the Women and Children's Affairs Committee to amend certain provisions of the Children's Law and rejected the draft law of the Public Utilities and Environment Affairs Committee. The council approved the proposal to allocate the next session to review the strategic plan for the implementation of the National Plan for the Advancement of Bahraini Women and the role of the legislative project prepared by the Supreme Council for Women and approved by His Majesty the King. Interior Minister Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa attended today the concluding ceremony of the Ministry of Interior's Olympic Shooting Championship in the presence of the Governor of the Southern Province, Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali Al Khalifa, President of the Bahrain Shooting Association, Sheikh Salman bin Khalid Al Khalifa, Chief of Public Security and the Undersecretary of the Ministry of Interior. The Minister and the attendees inspected the shooting ranges and the preparations alongside weapons and special equipment for the shooting teams. The minister witnessed the part of the final match, where he praised the outstanding skills and high level of the championship, as well as the competency shown by shooters. He expressed thanks and appreciation to the president of the Bahrain Shooting Association for his role in aiding the success of the championship and continuous cooperation and coordination with the Public Security Sports Association. For his part, the president of the Public Security Sports Association, Colonel Khalid Abdulaziz Al Khayyal, affirmed that thanks to the directives and keenness of the Interior Minister to implement advanced preparation programs and the follow-up of the Chief of Public Security, the Ministry has reinforced the culture of sports to all its affiliates. He added that the Association has exerted many efforts to implement the plan of the Interior Minister to develop the sports field according to high-quality training programs supervised by experienced trainers that contributed in developing the competency of the Association's teams. The Interior Minister and the Shooting Association President honored the winners in the four competitions for guns, pistols, shotguns and bow and arrows. The championship was organized by the Public Security Sports Association in cooperation with the Bahrain Shooting Association from February 19th to the 25th, with the participation of the Bahrain Defense Force and the National Guard. Under the patronage of the Minister of Industry, Commerce and Tourism, Zayed Rashid Al-Zayani, Bahrain Tourism and Exhibition Authority, the BTEA, has celebrated Arab Tourism Day. As Zayani said, in the Kingdom of Bahrain, the tourism sector is regarded as one of the leading economic sectors in terms of its contribution to the GDP and increasing employment rates, as well as its direct contribution to the achievement of the Sustainable Development Objectives. The contribution of tourism to the Kingdom's GDP is estimated at 6.8% in 2017, as the Kingdom plans to increase the contribution rate over the coming years. The minister added that according to the latest official statistics, tourism spending in 2017 amounted to more than 1.6 billion dinars at an annual growth rate of 8.9%. Chief Executive Officer of BTEA, Sheikh Khalid bin Hamoud Al Khalifa, highlighted the latest tourism developments, which were the result of the increase in tourism in the Kingdom, as an increase in the number of visitors, where the number of visitors to 11.4 million visitors grew by 11.9%. He added that the Arab Tourism Day is one of the most important regional initiatives aiming to achieve the objectives of the authority by providing a lot of fruitful investment opportunities in order to enhance the tourism sector and contribute to supporting the national economy effectively. The Royal Court Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to the first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Athletics Association, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, for ranking third in the lightweight class of the Bahrain Strongest Man Championship. The Royal Court Minister hailed the success of the two-day championship, which concluded yesterday in Bahrain, commending His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa for his efforts to ensure the success of the championship and his honorable performance. He also sent a cable of congratulations to East Rafah Chairman Captain Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa for ranking first in the middleweight class in the championship. He commended his achievements and determination, setting a role model for Bahrainis to honor their country in all sporting championships. Royal Courts Minister also sent a congratulatory cable to Ahmad Hussein Al Ghaffas on winning the first place ranking in the heavyweight class of the championship. The minister wished Ahmad Al Ghaffas more success in upcoming championships. The BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa sent a cable to the first President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, Chairman of the Bahrain Athletics Association, Honorary President of Bahrain Sports Federation for Disabilities, and Honorary President of the Bahrain Mixed Martial Arts Federation, His Honor Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, on winning third place in the lightweight category in the Strongest Bahraini Man competition and the great success achieved by the championship, which was held on the 23rd and 24th of February. In his cable, the BDF Commander-in-Chief has said that the success of the championship reflects the unlimited support enjoyed by the sports movement from the wise leadership and its keenness to provide all the reason for success. He noted the role of His Honor Sheikh Khalid and his efforts to ensure the success of the championship and his participation in supervising and providing all the reasons for success. The BDF Commander-in-Chief sent a similar cable to President of East Rafah Club, Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, on winning first place in the middleweight category. Information Minister Ali bin Mohammed Al-Rumaihi expressed appreciation for participating in the second edition of Fujairah International Arts Festival, which is organized by Fujairah Culture and Media Authority from February the 24th to March the 5th. The event is being held under the auspices of Member of the Supreme Federal Council and Ruler of Fujairah, Sheikh Hamad bin Mohammed Al-Sharqi, with the support of Fujairah Crown Prince, Sheikh Mohammed bin Hamad Al-Sharqi, and an invitation of President of the Authority and Head of the Festival's High Committee, Dr. Sheikh Rashid bin Hamad bin Mohammed Al-Sharqi. The Information Minister lauded strong historic and fraternal relations between Bahrain and the UAE and their growth in various fields. He described solid ties between both countries as a model to emulate under the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the UAE President Sana Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan. The Information Minister hailed the efforts of Fujairah Cultural and Media Authority in organizing the international festival as one of the outstanding artistic, cultural and media events at the regional and international level. He also praised the artistic shows with Arab and international participation that reflect coexistence between cultures and civilizations, pointing out the noble humanitarian and civilizational gesture of celebrating the commemoration of the late Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan. The policy impact of big data conference discussed the most important and recent developments in the use of massive data and methods of analysis to support the policy's assessment process in the public or private sector. The conference is sponsored by the Information and E-Government Authority and organized by Al Ithra Statistical Consultancy in collaboration with Ahliya University in the presence of more than 100 specialists in the field of statistical information and data provision from the public and private sectors. Large data volumes constitute a great importance in light of the global trend towards total dependence on this field in various areas. The conference, which is being held for the first time in the Gulf region and East Asia, aims at presenting practical experiences on the correct uses of policy evaluation through large data analysis methods. The international conference also contributes to the achievement of a goal of 9 Sustainable Development 2030 on innovative research infrastructure, which includes applied research for the use of large data in policymaking or correction.
I would like to really highly appreciate the leaders of the kingdom for giving such environment, providing such platform for the government to make decision. Education, which is my background and my initiative as the chief of the quality assurance authority in the kingdom, is of high priority to any country. And Bahrain has given that good room for improvement.
We discuss about the women's needs, and also we discuss small and medium needs and the programs to support SMEs, programs to support women, to support housing for the people, and also the discuss the how to support people in the health.